Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and you're listening to Subhash Chandran. In this video, we are going to discuss about pipe fitting fundamentals. But it is part 1 because pipe fittings has lots of information that a piping design engineer should know. So it is impossible to cover all the informations in one video. So I wanted to have a multiple video so that I can cover all the areas of pipe fittings. And for those who do not know about Pemidaka, Pemidaka is the name of this channel and I also own a website named Pemidaka. The intent of Pemidaka is to have a virtual piping design classroom because when I started my career, I could not find a place where I can learn the entire engineering process of piping design. There are institutes that teaches softwares and the basics of piping, but that doesn't help you to get a job or doesn't help you to do a real-time job. So that's what the intent of the Pemidaka. If you look at the word, the P stands for piping and the rest of the letters are just a reversal of academy. That's how I arrived this name Pemidaka. And for those who have not subscribed, I kindly request you to subscribe to my channel because that gives me a motivation to put more videos and to share more of my knowledge with you. Now let's get into the video. Let's understand what is pipe fittings. Pipe fittings are piping components in a piping system to achieve certain geometry as per the requirements of piping system. When we say certain geometry, it is a specific requirement based on the location or based on the process or based on the system that has been built. And the specific requirements are, one of the requirement is change in direction, the directional changes in piping. And the second requirement is change in size from higher size to a lower size. And the third requirement is to take branches. There will be a lot of branches in one connection. And the fourth one is to end cap the line, to arrest the line, to end the line. And the fifth one is to join different lines. So these are certain requirements where the piping components plays a vital role. Now let's see the types of piping fittings. There are different types of pipe fittings are generally used in piping design. One of the fitting is elbow, which is the very important fitting to help, which helps in change in direction of the piping. And the second one is T. T helps in taking branches. And the fourth one is reducer. Reducer helps in reducing the line size. And the O-lets. O-lets is also a fitting that is used to taking branches from the line. And rest all falls under other category. Let's go to the first component, elbow. Elbows are classified into many types. One of the first classification is based on angle of degree, which is 90 degree elbows and 45 degree elbows. And the second classification is based on geometry. Based on geometry, we have long radius elbows and short radius elbows. And the third classification is based on end connection. Based on end connection, we have butt well connection, socket well connection and screwed end connection. Let's see the details of each of these types. Based on angle of degree, we have 90 degree elbows and as well as 45 degree elbows. This is how it actually looks. 90 degree elbows are actually a 90 degree bend and 45 degree elbows has a 45 degree inclination. Based on the geometry of elbows, we have other two types. One is long radius and other one is a short radius. The difference between long radius and short radius is the dimension gave for long radius is 1.5 times of the diameter. But for short radius, it is 1 times of the diameter. That is the difference between long radius and short radius. And it is also same for 45 degree elbows. Long radius and short radius, the only difference is dimension A, which is 1.5 times for long radius, and for short radius, it is 1 time. Unfortunately, the dimension A is not shown here because it is already referred in 90 degree bend. For dimension A, you can refer the previous 90 degree elbow. Now let's see the elbows based on end connections. We have butt well connections and socket well connections and screwed end connections. Butt well connection, it looks like this, and socket well connections, it appears like this, and screwed end connection has a threaded end. So these are the different types. Basically, butt well connection is a welding joint directly pipe to pipe, and socket well connections is a socket inside the pipe where the pipe goes into the socket. And screwed end connection is a threaded connection. The next fitting is T. T's are also classified into various types. One of the type is based on reduction. Based on reduction, we have equal T and reduced T. And we have another type based on end connection. We have butt well ends, socket well ends and screwed ends. So based on reduction, as I said, we have equal T and reduced T. The only difference between equal T and the reduced T is In equality, the branch size is equal to the header size, which is the main size. Wherein, in reduced T, the branch size is lesser than, always one size lesser than the header size. That is why it is denominated as D1 in reduced T. You can see the difference from the picture. The main size is denominated as D and the smaller size is denominated as D1. This is the major difference between equality and reduced T. And the T's based on N connections are buttwell ends, socketwell ends and screwed ends. Now let's go to the other fitting, which is a reducer. Reducers are generally used to achieve the reduction in the pipe size or an expansion in the pipe size. So in reducers we have multiple types, which is based on geometry. Based on geometry we have concentric reducers and eccentric reducers. And the other type is based on end connections. We have buttwell ends, socketwell ends and screwed ends like elbows and T's. Let's see the based on geometry. So based on geometry we have two types, as I said, concentric and eccentric. The very important difference between the concentric reducers and eccentric reducers are, the first difference is the axis. If you look at the concentric reducers, the axis of the primary and the secondary reduced size are same, but wherein in eccentric reducers the axes are totally not in same line, it is in different location. And the second difference is that concentric reducers reduces concentrically, wherein in eccentric reducers you can find that, you can from the picture you can see, always one side of the reducer remains flat. This is the major difference between the concentric reducer and eccentric reducer. Now let's see based on end connections. We have buttwell and socketwell and screwed end connection. But the point over here is, the socket weld reducers are generally referred as swage. The main difference between the socket weld reducers and the other reducers are, we have an extended pipe at the ends of the reducer in socket weld type. So this is the major, from the picture you can see that extended pipe pieces are provided at the ends of the reducer. This is the major difference between other reducers and swage type of reducers. And screwed end, if you see, we have a threaded connection at the ends of the reducer. So this is the types of the reducers. The other type of fittings are wallets. Wallets are generally used to for taking branches. There are different types of wallets are available. We have weldolets and socolets and threadolets and elbowlets and sweepolets and lateralets. Let's see each of these types clearly. The first one is that weldolet. Weldolets are basically a butt weld ends at one end and the fillet type ends at the other end. So how it is used in piping? This is the picture. It exactly shows how the weldolets are used in the piping. Actually, it is placed over the pipe. It has a profile in such a way that it gets seated over the pipe and the pipes are welded onto the weldolet. Let's move on to the other fitting, socolet. Socolet are also a type of olet which is used for taking branches. The difference between the weldolet and socolet is, there is a socket inside the socolet. You can see from the profile, from the picture, that the pipe goes into the socolet. So there is a provision inside the socolet in such a way that the pipe can get into it. So this is known as socolet. And the third one is threadolet. Threadolet, from the name you can identify, threadolet is basically a threaded connection. So from the picture you can exactly understand that how the threadolets are placed over the pipe and how the pipes are connected. And the next one is, we have elbowlet. Elbowlets are generally placed or used at the elbows. Let's say for an example, you wanted to take a branch from the elbow. So this is not a common practice. Let me tell you that taking a branch from the elbow is not a common practice, because only at a specific cases where the instrument connections or any sort of an injection, very particular injection needs to be done, only then it will be used. But generally elbowlets are not used in common practice. Next one is the sweepolet. Sweepolet is also a type of fittings that is used for taking branches, which is basically an extruded pipes which has a provision to take branches. This is how it appears. You can refer the photo and as well as the drawing picture shown how it was placed over the pipe. The next one is lateralet. Lateral rods are generally used for taking branches at certain inclination, such as 45 degree angle. You can see from the picture that how the lateral rods are placed over the pipe and how the branches are taken. Now let's see other types of fittings that actually doesn't fall under the categories that we have seen so far. One of the type is cap. Caps are generally used to end the continuation of the line. So we have butt weld end caps and threaded end caps, and we do have a socket weld end caps, but generally butt weld ends are commonly used and threaded ends are also used, but it is at rare places it is used. In general, most of the places the butt weld end connection caps are used because the caps are generally placed in the bigger size piping, which is more than 2-inch sizes. The next fitting is nipple. Nipples are nothing but the piece of pipes which are available in various dimensions like 100 mm and 200 mm, and it is also available in thread ends and socket ends. And let me show you how the nipples are used, and this is how the nipples are used between your O-lets and the valves, and nipples are placed because for that you don't have to cut the pipes into small pieces. You can actually buy nipples which is of a smaller size, which is actually an equivalent of pipe, but it is available in smaller sizes. It helps you to reduce the cutting time of the pipe. The next fitting is plugs. Plugs are also a pipe fittings which are used in piping system to end cap the ends of the valves, which are available in two types, hexagonal head and the square head. The next fitting is coupling. Couplings are generally used to connect two different pipes, and it is available both in socket well ends and screwed ends. And the third picture that exactly shows the provision of the socket, where the pipe can enter into the socket from both the sides so that it can be welded. And in coupling we have another type called reduced coupling, where it helps in getting a reduction. So from at one end of the coupling we can have a higher size, and on the other end of the piping, other end of the coupling, we have a lower size. It is also available in both the socket well and screwed ends. The next fitting is union. Union is also a pipe fittings used to connect two different pipes without welding. Union has a provision to dismantle the piping without welding or without cutting. So that is the best part of union. And the next one is stub end. Stub ends are used in lap joint flanges, and it is available in shorter length and as well as longer length. Thank you so much, and thanks for listening to me. I believe this video will help you to understand the basic types of pipe fittings available in piping design. I will try to cover the more informations on the other parts, part 2 and part 3. And if you like this video, please like, give me a like and share with your friends, but I won't force you. If you feel this video needs to be liked, then you can give a like, and also you can also subscribe to my channel to motivate me so that I'll be able to put more videos and I'll share more of my knowledge with you. I will meet you in another video. Until then, bye from Subhash Chandran.